Hello. Happy Monday. It's a new week. It is time to finish up Doom. The original Doom. The original 1983 Doom. Inferno, the last of three episodes included in Doom, until Ultimate Doom when Thy Flesh Consumed was added. This is the denouement of the 1993 experience. So, the first two episodes took place on army bases on the two moons of Mars, Phobos and Deimos. This time, it's episode 3, Revenge of the Doom Guy. We are taking it to the monsters. I need to move my window up slightly. Hold on. Okay, there we go. So, first things first, a little bit of housekeeping. I figured out the issue I was having with my autosaves, and because I hate it when people say they solved a problem but don't explain how, just in case anyone else has had this issue. It's under gameplay options, I think. Miscellaneous options. Here we go. So this setting, for whatever reason, load all of these lumps. This was set to never, which I think was the default, and you just want to set that to all. And you shouldn't have any issues with autosaves, no matter what mods you're using. Okay, anyway, here we are in hell. And this level is interesting. This is the first time I've seen one where it is possible, with the Keymaster mod, to get yourself into an unfinishable situation. And I don't think this is going to be an issue going forward, at least I hope not. We get the arrow right off the bat here, which is nice, because this being the third episode and everything, they want to make sure you know how serious it is, so they give you a couple cockademons to kill with just your pistol. If I didn't get the arrow, I would probably just lure them out and then just not worry about them, which I might still do. Yeah, I don't need to kill those cockademons. They can just have a good time out here in Hell's Courtyard. So there's a shotgun out in the middle of this platform here, and you want to keep moving on this platform because it is going to disappear. And there is a secret wall here. And once this platform sinks, there's no way to get in here. So if the arrow spawned in this little chamber, I would have to restart the level if I had fallen and not been able to get in here. Once you're up here, you can circle around and you can open the secret panel, but this isn't openable from this side. At least I don't think it is. Oh, that just stays open. Okay. So yeah, once you fall, that's it. Actually, I don't know what the other way of getting up here is. There must be another door somewhere. Anyway, oh wait, right. I circle back around. Okay. I'll take care of this cockademon, because I have a shotgun now. So the other weird thing about this level I'll just take care of the Keymaster here. So once you go down this little hallway here, there's going to be a couple of doors, and they look similar to doors earlier in the level. But once this door closes again, you can't get back through. That's a one-way door, and I don't know why they designed it like that. It's not a glitch or anything, that's just how this level is. So if you had the arrow, if the arrow was in this room, you could probably, and you knew about this, you could probably grab it and then quickly run back out before the store closes if you needed to go back and kill the Keymaster. But if the arrow was, like, in here, like if the arrow replaced one of these items, you would have to start the level over. That's just because this one also is a one-way door, which is very strange. Oh yeah, there is the secret, which is nice, but this isn't actually a way back out. It's just a little standalone chamber with the rocket launcher. good to have, because if we don't get that, then we don't get the rocket launcher until pretty late in this episode otherwise, unless there's another secret I'm missing. Also, all of the exits, unlike the first three episodes, you flip a switch on the wall, these exits are all teleporters, so they will show up on the map as a green square instead of just a green line, making them a little bit easier to spot. And I think that's it for this level. I mean, that's definitely it for this level. It's very small. Sort of a weirdly designed one. And, of course, we don't get 100% because I left those two cockademons alive to tell others what transpired in Hell Keep. So this is Hell. We are no longer in our physical universe as we know it. I guess Hell Keep is the big building down towards the bottom where it has the time and the lava is flowing out of it, although I don't remember it looking like that. Okay, well, now we're over there on the left with those weird pillar objects, and this is the I don't know how to pronounce that word, the Slough of Despair, the Slough, Slough. I'm not sure what that actually means. I thought that Slough or Slough or however you say it was a verb. I've only heard it in the context of like someone's skin sloughing off. Sorry to be gross there, but this is Doom. Might have another meaning that I'm not aware of. Or it just means the act of sloughing. I think I saw the arrow over there. Over yonder. The music for this level, I picked one of the first really kind of noisy drones on the soundtrack, which I think it works. It might be a little bit too loud. Like, the volume that you want to listen to the cool psychedelic rock tracks at isn't the same as the volume that you want to listen to the drone tracks at, I think. I think the drone might work a little better if it's more subtle. But I don't think it's bad. So you step on this little lava pit here to reveal the chain gun, which is good because your ammo at this point in the game is pretty precarious. Oh, there's Zero. Okay. I don't know what I thought I saw before. Alright, step on that to lower all the stuff. Having the arrow replace one of the map, you know, one of the items that's already in the map is a super smart way of doing it, because that guarantees you'll always be able to pick it up, because there's not going to be an item that, you know, they place there that's impossible for the player to get, ideally, unless you play on some poorly designed maps by fans. So this thing closes behind you, and it's actually possible to get yourself permanently stuck in this level, which is weird. So this switch at the end of this hallway, that opens this door again, but it's actually possible to flip the switch before the door is fully finished closing, and if you do, there's just no way out. Oh yeah, it also reveals this friend. Bang, scream, whoosh. Bang, scream, whoosh. Ah! The last soul spooked me a little bit. I don't think there's anything behind any of these. Okay. So, that's good. I can just go to the exit once I remember where it is. Oh god. I did not notice that it switched to the rocket launcher. Or I did, but by the time I did, it was too late. Luckily, that thing wasn't closer to me, or my goose would have been cooked. Found a box of shells there. That's nice. A lot of these big stone pillars open up as events transpire in the map, giving you access to more goodies and more baddies. And a few uglies. God, it's nice to be able to one-shot a lost soul with a shotgun. The worst thing about the lost souls is just how much damn health they have. Like, I think they have as much health as a demon, which it really does not look like they should. And having a monster that is that tough flying around, able to attack you from any angle, and needing basically 3 shotgun hits to get rid of them, it's not a good time. Also, you might have noticed that this map is a hand, sort of. The thumb doesn't really fully fill in for some reason. But it's clearly in the shape of a grasping, claw-like hand. So the Architects of Hell had some fun with this one. Try to gather as many resources as I can before venturing forward. I wonder which of these I should press. I want to say this one. Nice. If you flip the wrong one, it's not that big a deal. You just have a few specters to deal with. And a bunch of rockets, which is nice. Maybe that's why they call this level the Slough, because of the hand shape. It's referring to, like, the skin of the hand sloughing off. Degloving, if you will. Okay, exit. Oh, press a button. Hi. Dang, even once you get the computer map, it still doesn't fill in the thumb. Actually, I guess it's more than just a thumb. Something that it's probably best not to think about. Alright. And teleporter out. That is the Slough of Despair. Now we are in Pandemonium. Oh, I wonder if like it was pointing at the central the central tower there. I wonder if it's inspired by like a panopticon, like if that's what they were going for, like panopticon, pandemonium, pan galactic gargle blaster. I'm probably aggroing more enemies than I actually have to here, but thanks to the Arrow of Slaying and the Master Key, I was able to conserve more ammo than I usually am able to going into this level, so I have enough resources to deal with it. I think I remember there being a secret close to one of these entrances. But maybe I'm thinking of a similar level. They're really good about differentiating levels with the level design and the architecture, but because there are only so many textures and so many different ways that you can arrange them, you do occasionally have a sense of deja vu. Ow. Dang, these walls are moving. I don't remember that effect. It's like I'm in a Jamiroquai video. Oh. It's you. The straggler. Oh boy. I'll come back for you. An important thing to internalize about Doom, if you want to be good at it, is that not every threat has to be dealt with immediately. A single Baron of Hell shambling around is going to move slowly, its pathfinding is not going to be great, it's going to get stuck on doors, and it might even take out a few other enemies while it's on the hunt for you. And sure, that doesn't apply to every level or every situation, but when it is applicable, when you can just sort of leave something for later, you may be better equipped to deal with it. Also, it actually prevents you physically from stepping onto the teleporter, which is interesting. I'm not sure how the creator of the mod did that. Of course, this mod is made with ZScript, which is a GZ Doom specific scripting language that I have not messed with. And what little I did mess with it, it seemed very confusing and hard to figure out. All of my modding is just with basic object replacement, so I can't actually script new events or, you know, place text or icons or anything on the screen, which I misspoke in a previous video when I was talking about my mod, how I replaced the invincibility item with one that doesn't change the screen color. It still changes the screen color because I would need to learn how to do the scripting stuff to actually place an icon on the screen, which would be my preference, but it changes it to a much more muted color. That doesn't make it impossible to see stuff like the inverse black and white effect does with the actual invincibility item. I don't have a chainsaw yet, do I? No. I wish I did. Although, speaking of chains, I'm gonna have to switch out to the chain gun here pretty soon. Well, there's the Keymaster. See if the arrow is in the intestines room here. No. But a Baron is. Oh man, there's two of them. Okay, I'm gonna have to actually take care of some business here. This Baron is being a real wise guy. Okay, that Baron is stuck on a low ceiling, so I think. As long as I don't stand here and let it fireball me, I should be okay. This Baron is being a real pain in the butt. They really turn up the heat for episode 3. This would probably be a good situation to utilize a ranged explosive device. Well, let's see here. I might have to run past the Keymaster because the arrow is definitely off in this direction. I may have to go into some other areas just to try to find some ammo. The ammo situation is getting a little dire. Oh, there we go. Okay. Excellent. So I got the Berserk box, or the Berserk pack, or whatever you want to call it. So I want to let those two duke it out. I don't think the Keymaster enemies actually deal more damage. I think they just have way more health and are way faster, which is enough to be a threat. But with Lost Souls, if you're only facing one, it's doable to punch them to death. Also, this is a situation that would not have happened in the original Doom without the engine replacement I'm using, being able to look down from up here and shoot these guys. Which, I mean, that's something that Doom Guy would be able to do, but I mean, in real life, if he was actually in hell looking down at a pit with some demons, you know, he could just aim downwards. But it's something that they designed the level around, so that is technically cheating. But those kinds of situations don't come up too often. All right. There's quite a bit of this level left to explore, which I might want to do now that I am at full power. It might be prudent to check some of these other areas looking for ammo or health. I mean, I'm at 100, but you could always do more. Oh, there's some shotgun ammo. That's good to see. I don't think that switch does anything but lower that platform again. Alright, there's some cells, which I still don't have a weapon with which to use them. Oh, wait. Why does this hurt me? This is water. What is deadly about this water? Explain that to me, someone. John Romero, if you're watching, explain yourself. I'll be fine. There's always more where that came from. House of Pain. We are in a building shaped like a skull called the House of Pain. Pack it up. Pack it in. Let me begin. Etc. That's all I know. Except for jump around. Oh, there would be no jumping around in this house of pain. That is one barrier that I won't cross. Unless I come to a level that's really annoying, and I can mitigate a lot of the annoyance by jumping over something. Which might happen. Not in Doom 1, I don't think. Doom 2, the levels get a lot more vertical than Doom 1, a lot more open and vertical. And there are some situations where you have to quote-unquote jump over a gap by just running across something at full speed. And, oh, there you are. It can be a little difficult to tell where you're being shot from sometimes. But yeah, Doom 2 has a lot of little gaps that you have to run over at full speed to get across them. And that's always an action that I found not intuitive, getting up to full speed. If it doesn't give you room to. I'm trying to remember how to actually... I want both of these crushers to be crushing before I start doing stuff here. Okay. So it's safe to just grab this. And then... I'm sure it's giving me this invulnerability for a reason. So I guess I might as well use it. As much as it pains me. This was probably a cool technical effect in 1993. I'm sure doing this on the computer hardware, on the graphics hardware of the time, wasn't the easiest thing in the world, but I just find it very unpleasant. You know, the first time I played Doom on the 32X, that version of the game, it had a lot of limitations that I've gone into a little bit, as far as not having transparency effects and stuff. One of the major limitations that totally changes how the game plays is that the enemies can only be viewed from the front. In the PC version and all other versions, well, except maybe some of the more fiddly console versions, but, you know, in the versions of the game that matter, the enemies have 8 sprites, they can be viewed from 8 directions, and that is crucial to monster infighting, which is a big part of the game. A lot of the levels were probably designed with infighting in mind. Like, the first level of this episode, they probably, since they only gave you a pistol and very little ammo, they probably intended you to let the cacodemons out and start them infighting with the imps. Which, because I knew how much ammo I had and because I had the arrow, so I had some extra damage, you know, I didn't have to go that route, but it's definitely a strategy. And, well, this episode wasn't in the 32X version, but if it was, that would have been, you know, impossible, because the enemies are always facing directly at you, no matter what, you know, you can circle around them all day long, and they will continue. It's like the corpse sprite, like you see how as I circle strafe around it, no matter what direction I look at it from, it's still facing me. It's like that with the monster sprites in the 32X version. So yeah, largely changes the dynamic of the game. Of course, enemies can still damage each other, so I suppose I could have the cacodemons and the imps just throwing stuff at me and they just get hit in the crossfire. but that's not nearly as effective as actually making them target each other, which is one of the most fun things about Doom, I think. Monster infighting in general is just it's a really fun time. I like it when monsters fight each other. I like when monsters are affected by the same traps that the player is. It makes the world feel consistent and logical. Especially when you can strategize around that. And some people might say, oh, it doesn't make sense that these demons would turn on each other like that. You know, you're the threat. Why would they turn on each other because of friendly fire? And, you know, this is hell. These are demons. They are not logical beings. You know, they are innately violent, malevolent entities. Oh, I probably could have brought my rocket launcher out there and did a little bit more damage since they weren't aware of me yet, but, you know, you see a big group of enemies like that, it really makes you want to shoot them. Well, the ammo situation is getting a little hairy. Oh yeah. Well, I'm glad I thought to check that. Dang. Look at all those rockets. And a bunch of cells I can't do anything with yet. These imps won't be aware of me until I shoot them, or until I'm in their line of sight, or until I get close enough to them. I was wondering if I could get the Spectre to turn on the imps. Oh boy. Oh boy. Got a Baron of Hell and the Keymaster, and the Keymaster is a demon, which is scary. Oh god. Oh man, this thing is so fast. I don't like it. Enemy should not be that fast. It's not natural. Ah! Oh boy. Alright. I'm gonna grab that soul sphere and get the heck out of here. I deserve that. I deserve that too. Stop having the rocket launcher out. Oh, hey. I'll have this out. Damn, it gives me a BFG on level 4? That's quite generous of it. I got the BFG before the plasma gun. Oh, that soul sphere is almost completely depleted. Oh, well. Easy come, easy go. I'm expecting this door to close. That's weird. Never seen it stay open like that before. Usually that door closes and you have to step in this little puddle here to open it, which is... It's memorable because it's a strange switch. Oh, right, this part. I find this part confusing and a little annoying. Okay, so there are four chambers there, or four passages. And to open them, you flip these switches, And the only way to really tell what you're doing is to listen for the door opening sound. And you're not sure which doors are opening when you do that. Okay, I think I found the right one here. Do I even need to go this way? I haven't found the exit yet, have I? And I'm just forgetting about it. I was looking at my map. Thank you very much, Mr. Cockademon. Mr. or Ms. Cockademon. Oh, hey. Well, that makes this part less scary. Because this floor is made of lava. And it would be doing harm to my body if I didn't get the radiation suit here. I don't know why the radiation suit protects you from lava. It's radioactive lava, okay? And in hell, it's not hot because everything is hot. You know, compared to the ambient temperature, the lava is no warmer than everything else, so the Doom Slayer has acclimated to it. So, it's just the radiation that he has to worry about. And eventually, he'll acclimate to the radiation too. This is a weird staircase. Very, very steep. Looks unpleasant to climb. Eventually, he'll acclimate to the radiation too, and then he'll be unstoppable. Ah. Nice try, game. Alright, that will do it for the House of Pain. We are at exactly 35 minutes, making a good pace. Unholy Cathedral. We're halfway through episode 3. The music for this one is very spoopy. I hope it's not too spoopy. Oh, I remember this level. Oh, this has all kinds of like mandatory walking on lava sections with teleporter mazes. It's just not a pleasant time. I guess it doesn't have that much walking on lava stuff. But the teleporter mazes are a thing. I'm not a fan of them. Getting used to not having the quad damage. It's always a little sad. Going back to just normal shotgun levels. But you know, it inspires you. It makes you want to press forward and find the arrow again. So you can once again feel the power of the Keymaster. I assume that the key is what makes the monsters stronger and faster, and not the other way around. Like, it's not like they just chose the fastest, strongest imp or whatever to be the Keymaster. You know, the power of the key was bestowed unto him or her. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say most of the monsters in Doom probably male. You know, it would be nice if you could have a female playable character. That's one thing that I think, you know, even today would be a nice inclusion. You know, more of a character creation process, or at least, you know, have a choice of character to play as, rather than just always playing as a male character. But I don't think gender inclusivity is really necessary for the monsters. I mean, they're kind of genderless, really, except for the Baron. That is a, you know, Baron is a title reserved for men, so that is the one monster that is unambiguously male. All the rest of them, you know, could go either way. You don't know. Actually, the Hell Knight might be, I don't know. Are there women knights? If not, there should be. Sneak attack bonus. Man, it sucks that they become aware of you the second you pull the trigger. Like, even before you would think that you made any noise, they are on you. Feels like they should become aware of you when they're hit by the projectile. And like, it makes sense with the loud weapons, but the rocket launcher is pretty quiet until the rocket hits, or until the rocket whooshes. I kind of expected something to open here. Dang, 2 double damage shotgun blast to kill a demon. Alright, we have another odd switch here. You walk through this little archway. I guess demons are tough. I guess, yeah, I mean, that makes sense. They normally take 3 shotgun blasts to take down. So, it makes sense that they would take the equivalent of 4 rather than the equivalent of 2. Also, I still don't have a plasma rifle, do I? I might actually get one here. I seem to remember there being one here. This area can be kind of confusing. Like, it sure doesn't look like these platforms should be something that you're able to step onto. But if you look carefully at them, I think you can make out just a very slight incline compared to what's next to it. But yeah, you can step up onto these little blue platforms, and there are switches there, which not super intuitive. I guess the fact that there are switches there should be a clue that you can walk up there, but I definitely remember having trouble with that in the past and being a little annoyed when I figured out that that's the solution. That's one of those situations where I would probably default to just using the jump key. And then in that process, I probably would just figure out that you can step up there. Because these don't look like things you want to step onto, because you're going to get crushed. It's not something, you know, you're going to want to experiment with. Okay, no plasma rifle, just a chain gun. Oh well, that's fine. And then this one opens up into a little teleporter here, and it just takes you back out here. Alright, there should be some baddies waiting for me out here now. So I'll try to be ready for them. Well, no? Still not? Okay, I don't know what the actual trigger for them is then. Oh, this baddie's out. Alright, there's a path in here. Oh. I wonder why this was revealed. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. It's this little window here. I just happened to get lucky and find a radiation suit. Nice. Any other secrets in here? Okay, well, where else can I go? I don't know how you actually figure out which one of those teleporters is the one you're looking for. I just kind of trial and error my way through until I stumble on the right one. Oh, something looks strange about that wall. Guess not. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, there's another kind of substantial part of this level that I guess I don't have to do now. If I go in there, lots and lots of enemies will start teleporting in, and it's going to be a bad time. But I don't have to worry about it. Unholy Cathedral? You have been bested. Mount Erebus. Alright, level 6 of 8. So this level has a lot of mandatory damage floor tiles, lava tiles, and that kind of thing is my least favorite aspect of Doom level design, because, oh, well, looky there, because you've all watched me play video games, it can sometimes take some time and experimentation for me to figure out what I'm supposed to be doing. And when my health is slowly being whittled away by lava tiles as I explore a level, it makes it a bit frustrating. Hopefully that won't be an issue here, because I do remember somewhat what I need to do. Yeah, this is probably the most open level we've seen so far. And we get a nice wide vista of hell here. I was admiring the scenery, you jerk. See, this is why no one ever visits hell. If this is how you treat tourists. Of course, the skybox does look a little weird, how it just kind of fades into a solid color at the top, but of course you were never meant to be able to look at it from that angle, so I forgive it. I mean, pretty decent looking scenery for what it is. It's more interesting than any of the sky boxes in the Phobos levels, that's for sure. But I mean, those levels were all almost entirely indoors, so it's not like you had that many opportunities to look at the sky. Oh, that is a lot of lost souls. Which way is the arrow? I would like to find the arrow quickly if possible. Alright, it's looking like it's in this little outbuilding here. Yeah, this is kind of a preview of Doom 2, this level, because Doom 2 has a lot of open areas, a lot of dudes sniping at you from windows. Oh yeah, I guess Zombie Man and Shotgun Guy are two other enemies that are definitively male. But, you know, the demons, the imps, you know, who knows? They could be all genders. You know, we don't know how hell reproduction works. Or hell gender identity. Honestly, I don't want to know. They had their chance to be welcomed by the community, and they blew it when they invaded the Mars bases. I think I saw Sparkly somewhere. I should grab this invincibility. Yeah, I guess I didn't see a Sparkly. Or if I did, it was a mirage. It's hard to tell when everything is bright and searing white. I never did actually explore this outbuilding. I got distracted by some jerks. You know, I don't know why this game got so much guff about being satanic. You know. Oh, hey. Normally there's a... Is this where the plasma gun normally is? I think it might be. I think I might have just lost the plasma gun. Oh well, that's okay. But it seems to me like this game is pretty firmly anti-Satan. Like, you're definitely not supposed to sympathize with the demons of hell in this game, you know? You are a crusader. You know, if you had slapped some more Christian imagery in this game and called it a Bible game. Some people probably wouldn't have blinked an eye at it. I guess a big part of the religious right in the 90s was the appearance of being anti-violence. So it doesn't matter if you're being violent towards literal hell monsters. That's apparently bad for some reason. I'd like to get myself up as close to 100 as possible before I get that soul sphere. Try to maximize its value here. Oh, there's a plasma gun. Ah, excellent. And I have full ammunition for this sucker. I think it's time to go a little hog wild. Alright. So it looks like the Keymaster is probably hidden inside one of these structures that hasn't opened yet. Oh wait, no, I know where the Keymaster is. I just never actually came in here. All of these corpses are people I killed from the outside. Okay, there we go. Excellent. Alright, so now I just need to grab that soul sphere and see if I remember how the heck to finish this level. I think the exit is close to the soul sphere, actually. And it's in a place that you don't really, or, you know, I wouldn't have expected that to be the exit, crud. So yeah, see that little unassuming door next to the building where the soul sphere is? I think that's it. I think that's the exit. Which is very strange. Maybe I should have gotten one of those radiation suits before I came in here. Oh well. So there the exit, the teleporter was beside the door, which is kind of weird. Alright, level 7. Gate to Limbo. You are here. Limbo, over there, I assume. Hey! Now that was just really uncool. You should never... Oh. Enemies should never be aware of you as you spawn, in my opinion. You should at least be able to take stock of the situation and look at the environment before you have to worry about shooting stuff or being shot at. Demons, as we all know, immune to radioactive lava. They're on their home turf, so it's not surprising. So this level we can sequence break quite a bit because it is heavily designed around key puzzles, even more so than the previous levels. So we can sort of take this at our own pace. Okay, well that arrow could be anywhere off in the distance there. Hi. I was just looking at you. Okay, so this is the exit teleporter. Okay, so I want to do something that, as far as I know, has always been in Doom, but I think very few people are aware of this. I'm going to press the M key and make a mark on the map, which is it's a purple zero because the marks are numbered starting from zero. Just so I remember, this is where I need to go once all the stuff is done, once the exit is accessible. Which it can be a useful feature. It's a little... ambiguous, I guess. Since the only identifying information you can have is, numbers. It would be nice if you could actually type a note. That would be pretty rad. But, 1993, again, you have to cut them a little bit of slack. Also, this demon is going to be a thorn in my side. Okay, see, if I had looked at my map, I would have known that would just take me here. Although, I did kind of forget about this area. So, this is one of those situations where you can get up to speed and run across this gap to get over there. And for a long time, I thought that was something you actually had to do, but there is a switch that raises a platform that lets you get over there. I just need to find it. There was a lot of health in there and a radiation suit. I should get that. I hate getting a full med kit when I'm at almost 100% health, because it feels like a waste, but I guess there are quite a few of them. Alright, so that's the switch that raises that platform, so I can get the yellow key, even though I don't actually need to. It's good to do everything just in case it triggers something else to open. And then from here, you can run across this gap pretty easily and get to this plasma launcher. Oh, hi. I think I will grab that before I take out the Baron. Does this actually hurt you? This is another thing that bugs me, is inconsistent lava tiles. Like, this really looks like this should be doing damage to me, because it... Well, yeah, I guess it's a different texture, and it's not moving. But it looks like a texture that should hurt me. Okay, so that just takes me back here. Means I probably want to go through this blue door. All right. Hello. Yeah, this is probably my favorite Bull of Heaven track. And we'll probably finish the level before it really gets past the intro. This track is like 2.5 hours long, and it's very diverse. It's very eclectic. There's a lot of stuff going on in this track, and we'll hear like 5% of it, but that's fine. It does its job. Alright, the little section there that I missed up above where my arrow is, and in order to get there I'm going to have to go through the central chamber and then north. I wonder if this giant octagon-shaped room is going to have monsters in it. Seems like a weird feature to put here, if you don't put monsters in it. Okay, that's the exit teleporter. Don't want to go there. See, my mark helped, because there are three teleporters... Oh. On this level, in little sectioned-off chambers like that. And it can be very difficult. My prediction came true. It can be very difficult to tell, or remember, for me anyway, which one is which. So, having that mark there helps. Okay, there's actually a whole other teleporter on this side that I haven't done yet. It's through here. No, it's not. I have done that one. Oh, there's a platform, so I can actually get across here now. That's nice. Take care of these cockos. They didn't really come out of their little chambers. I'm surprised. I wonder if there's some sort of invisible barrier preventing them from flying out. I kind of expected them to get out and try to grab me. Right, so we have this whole underground lava maze, which is annoying, but at least it gives you enough radiation suits. You can't accuse the game of being stingy with the radiation suits. Oh, I don't know if I was ready to do that yet. I'm going to say probably. I got the red key, which is probably what they intended you to do there. So this is the other teleporter chamber, which... Oh, that door was already open. Oh, I must have... Did I step through it and then immediately... No, I haven't been in this area at all. But anyway, that should be the one that raises the platform to get to the yellow door, which is where the exit is. So now I just need to find the teleporter that I marked, which is up there. Probably won't get there before the radiation suit runs out. Oh, no, that is not open yet. There is another step. Don't think it's that. Ah, crud. See, that's what I mean. Having to run across those gaps. It's an inexact science. There might be more stuff in the lava maze I need to do. Oh, wait. Oh, right, that just lowers that platform. Okay. Let's go have a look at the lava maze. Oh. Were those stairs always there? I guess they were. Right. I don't know. I'm confused. But let's finish up the lava maze, see if there's anything in here we missed. Oh, well, that's the thing I missed. I mean, I already had one, but... it's good that it's there, just in case. Okay, what am I missing? There's still stuff in the lava maze that I missed, but I don't think there's anything else I actually need to do there. It bugs me how some pieces of the map just don't fill in. And I don't know why. I don't know if it's something with GZ Doom, or if it was always like that. Flip that switch, nothing else over here. Okay, I just thought I would ride that up real quickly and see if there was anything there. Alright, well, I guess let's finish filling this crap in. Alright, there's some rockets. Good. Go through here. Alright, there's the shotgun guy. There's a passage here. That is nothing, it looks like. And there is a section. No? Alright, well, just for my own sanity, let's fill in as much of this. Okay, that's all of it. You're not missing anything. Or I'm not missing anything. I don't know why I instinctively speak in the royal we whenever I do videos like this. I mean, it's called a let's play. You know, let us play. But, I mean... it feels weird to me to always say we instead of I, and it's just like a habit, I guess. Because, I mean, you're not playing. You are enjoying my gameplay. Feels a little bit like when people who watch sports refer to their team as we. You know, refer to the people playing the game as themselves. I guess this is kind of the opposite of that. And it's not the same thing, but... I'd still... Wait a sec. Okay, so the yellow door... Right, the yellow door isn't the exit. That's another Okay, so how do I get to the yellow door? Oh, see? I thought I could run across this gap, and I just got caught on the geometry. Alright, there must be another teleporter that I haven't been through. I haven't been through the central one. Or I was, but I couldn't do anything here. Okay, so now I can access this room. I can flip that switch. I can come back in here. I can go to where my mark is, over there on the left. I'm pretty sure that's always been in Doom. Because if you look at the read this. Yeah, see, M for marketplace, C to clear marks. And then you can zoom in and out with the plus and minus keys if you don't want to use the scroll wheel. So yeah, that function has always been there, but I didn't use it until very recently. Done. 3 hundos. That's a perfect score in Doom and in bowling. Wait, dis? I thought I was supposed to be going to Limbo. Wasn't that the gate to Limbo? Alright, so boss level. Level has no exit switches, so it is just a vanilla boss run. And this is going to be a very short level, because the boss of this episode is the Spider Mastermind. And pretty much all you gotta do, I mean, there's other stuff on this level. There's a Baron and a Cockademon, but you don't have to worry about them. Well, you don't have to worry too much about them. The music gets very spooky and loud, but I didn't let it. Oh, the loathsome spider demon that masterminded the invasion of the moon bases. A spider mastermind, if you will, and caused so much death has had its ass kicked for all time. Yeah, I'd say I BFG'd that thing pretty good. A hidden doorway opens. Where was this doorway? Who knows? And you enter. You've proven too tough for hell to contain, and now hell at last plays fair. For you to emerge from the door to see the green fields of Earth. Home at last. You wonder what's been happening on Earth while you were battling Evil Unleashed. It's good that no Hellspawn could have come through that door with you. Dot dot dot. This is a very confusing ending. Like, I think this is supposed to represent skyscrapers on Earth. Like, I don't think this is supposed to be some sort of demonic hell structure that the demons built. But the perspective, the way everything is all topsy-curvy, makes it look like that. And then, like, the sky is red. So demons have clearly invaded Earth, but like, I don't know what all these skyscrapers in the middle of a grassy field are supposed to be, like what city this is supposed to be. So it looks very odd and out of place. And then like, the bunny is totally like, they did some weird joke where the Doom guy, like, to give the Doom guy a motivation for continuing to fight against hell, they did a thing where like the demons killed his bunny and he's getting revenge or something, and it really doesn't explain that at all. You just see this very unnecessarily grotesque image of a rabbit. And is it impaled on a stake, or is that supposed to be the Doom guy holding it? Like, it looks, I guess that's a wooden stake, but like, it looks like an arm. It's just not very odd for the end of Doom. I bet a lot of people were confused by this at the time. I know I was when I saw it. But of course, that isn't the end. Because there are two additional levels for Doom 1. Well, there's one, Thy Flesh Consumed, which is the bonus episode that was added for the Ultimate Doom package. There's also Sigil, which is the recent episode, unofficial episode that John Romero released recently. And I'm probably going to play through that as well. Maybe not on Ultra Violence, because that one can get pretty overwhelming. And I'll have to set up some sort of autosave system, which I will probably do for this episode, because I'm not familiar with it, and these levels are pretty large, and I don't want to waste too much time. But that'll be an episode for another day. So thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.